Ugh. No, guys. Ugh. Food coma. Good day, everyone. Amy here on DNews. It's the holidays, which means it's time to visit family and eat a startling number of ginormous meals, which will undoubtedly come with the all-too-familiar food coma. Though it sounds kind of funny and made up, a food coma is actually a real, medically recognized condition. Properly called postprandial somnolence, it's that sensation of being so deliciously full that you can't move until you eventually fall asleep. A food coma comes down to a shift in activity in the autonomic nervous system. It's a system that controls involuntary action of the organs, heart, and glands, and it incorporates the sympathetic nervous system, which is responsible for the fight or flight response, as well as the parasympathetic nervous system that lets your body rest and digest. After ingesting a large meal, the autonomic nervous system starts favoring the parasympathetic nervous system, decreasing your awareness in your sympathetic nervous system, making you feel lethargic. But more often, turkey is the common scapegoat. The myth always circulates around the holidays that tryptophan in turkey gives you that sleepy feeling. It's partly true. Tryptophan is an amino acid that produces serotonin in the brain for that sated feeling, and serotonin produces the hormone melatonin that makes you feel sleepy. But tryptophan is also found in other poultry and meats, cheese, yogurt, fish, and eggs. Basically, things non-vegans eat throughout the year, so you can't really blame turkey, which, incidentally, actually has less tryptophan than chicken. Tryptophan binds to other proteins in the blood, but it's too bulky to easily make it through the blood-brain barrier. Other smaller proteins get through more easily, preventing tryptophan from entering the brain, so it can't trigger the production of serotonin or melatonin. Tryptophan needs help, and it gets it from carbohydrates. Yep, carbs are the culprit behind food comas. So here's how it works. Ingesting carbs stimulates insulin production, the hormone that helps your body turn sugar into energy. Insulin also helps drive protein out of the bloodstream and into cells. Some proteins remain in the blood, like the protein albumin that binds to tryptophan. So if levels of tryptophan in the blood are lower than other protein levels, the sudden loss of protein from the blood after the rise in insulin makes it so the relative amount of tryptophan rises. It's now the more dominant protein and it has less competition. It has a much easier time getting through the blood-brain barrier, which lets it hit the brain to make serotonin and melatonin. And it gets better. Because tryptophan can be stored in your body, you can get the carb-induced food coma long after you've finished dinner. That slice of pumpkin pie might be the carb hit your body needs to start the process that makes serotonin. So go ahead and eat your massive holiday meal and enjoy knowing exactly why you're going to fall asleep at the table. Though how your body handles tryptophan-bound proteins can change if you're sick or on medications, so everyone's food coma will be a little bit different. And speaking of turkey, Anthony and Kristen talk about why turkey gets such a bad rep for being the food that makes you so sleepy in this video right here.
Protein fat loading induces drowsiness, and not to mention how all of the blood directed to our gastrointestinal systems to digest that mound of Thanksgiving turkey diverts blood flow from the brain,
yes,
which once again is linked to sleep.
We'll put a link in the description below if you're on mobile. So what's your favorite holiday dish? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.